the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. We remind ourselves it's the month of May, and our months we have in the church, we honor Mary, the mother of Jesus. And isn't it nice to hear the opening hymn there in honor of Mary, the mother of Jesus? And most appropriate, because we are burying somebody here today who carried for her lifetime the name of Mary, same as the Jesus' mother, Mary Burke. So on behalf of all gathered, on behalf of the parish at large, on behalf of the congregation at present, we extend our sympathies to all the family and to the near relatives. We're conscious of your loss today and your human sadness at the passing from this world of Mary. But let her be among the saints in glory and with Mary, mother of Jesus as well, as we honor her today. So we ask in this Mass then that we are part of Mary's story, and that we're praying the funeral Mass for her. This Mass would have been foreseen from all eternity by Almighty God as part of Mary's journey to Him. And we're asking then that she be cleansed of her human imperfections and counted among the saints in glory. So brothers and sisters, then at the start of Mass, we call to mind our own weaknesses and we ask for God's pardon. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask Blessed Mary, the Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Lord, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. We turn to God then in the opening prayer. Listen kindly to our prayers, O Lord, as our faith in your Son, raised from the dead, is deepened. May our hope of resurrection for your departed servant Mary also find new strength through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. Amen. We sit now for the readings.
First reading is a reading from the first letter of St. John. My dear people, let us love one another, since love comes from God. And everyone who loves is begotten by God and knows God. Anyone who fails to love can never have known God, because God is love. God's love for us was revealed when God sent into the world his only Son, so that we could have life through him. This is the love I mean. Not our love for God, but God's love for us when he sent his Son to be the sacrifice that takes our sins away. We ourselves have known and put our faith in God's love towards ourselves. God is love. And anyone who lives in love lives in God, and God lives in him. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
My hand will sing. I need stars of night.
The second reading is a reading from the Acts of the Apostles. Then Peter began to speak. I now realize how true it is that God does not show favoritism, but accepts from every nation the one who fears him and does what is right. You know the message God sent to the people of Israel, announcing the good news of peace through Jesus Christ, who is Lord of all. He commanded us to preach to the people and to testify that he is the one whom God appointed as judge of the living and the dead. All the prophets testify about him, that everyone who believes in him receives forgiveness of sins through his name, the word of the Lord.
Thanks be
to God.
The Lord be with you. It's a reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Martha said to Jesus, if you had been here, my brother would not have died. But I know that even now, whatever you ask of God, he will grant you. Your brother, said Jesus to her, will rise again. And Martha said, I know he will rise again at the resurrection the last day. And Jesus said, I am the resurrection, the life. If anyone believes in me, even though he dies, he will live. And whoever lives and believes in me will never die. Do you believe this? Yes, Lord, she said, I believe that you are the Christ, the Son of God, the one who is to come into this world. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise
to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Just sit briefly. Millions upon millions of pounds, euros, dollars, whatever mentioned, has been spent over the last several years in the exploration of space itself. Now the equipment as used today is so sophisticated, all sorts of satellites out there, and various, let's say, things from the astronomical world, observing the heavens and so forth, in the search for what? First of all, I suppose for new information about our world itself, our creation, with the billions upon billions of stars, the galaxies. And every day there's new things being discovered. And we discovered how vast, how huge, how interesting the whole world out there is, way beyond our own little galaxy. And part two, of course, apart from finding out information about the makeup of creation, is that search for, is there any other life form out there? So far, nothing has been yielded to us. So much of creation is inert and without life. But the search goes on. Is there anything out there at all? Indeed, if anything is ever out there at all, you can be sure of one thing is, it is not human life. It's not, because human life is evolved from our own little planet. So we can't expect something else to turn up in another part of the galaxy totally, you know, the same as ourselves. No. It's remarkable, isn't it? And against that huge background, people feel their own smallness against creation. And the skies have always intrigued people, the stars and whatnot, the constellations and everything else. But, as I said again, we're searching for something. Is there anything out there at all? And the thought comes about how small we are. And that was sensed long before the Gospels were written. In the Old Testament, in one of the Psalms, Psalm 8, I think it is, there is mention within that little short psalm, short prayer, short hymn, if you like, about what is man that you should, God, that you keep him in mind. Man's such a small creature, and why is it that God should keep him in mind? Here's the thought of the psalm writer long before the gospel, long before the time of Christ, thinking about the smallness of himself and his own known world was only somewhere in the Middle East. So there's a question mark then about our own smallness and our importance. Now, the wonderful thing about from our point of view of followers of Christianity is that we see an awful lot of answers have come to us by way of revelation itself, whereby God himself has revealed himself to us. That's to be found there within the page of the Bible itself. God revealing his face to us. So there is a certain answers have come to us. And one of the great answers that has come to us from the scriptures is that we do matter. That we do matter and that we are important. And that we have a future beyond this little world of ours that's so circumcised by the planets and whatnot. There's something greater planned for us as well by the creator of all things. God is not just another figure out there in space. God is beyond all of creation and everything else. Now, in the weekend mass, here, what was read from it was the ending of Matthew's gospel. And we come across a great promise there and also a great revelation. And I read the line to which was read yesterday, the mass of the weekend. And this is the voice of Jesus, the very last line of Matthew's gospel. And it says, "And know that I am with you always, yes, to the end of time." Now, God could have left us in ignorance, and he could be with us until the end of time. But he wants to know that he is with us. Because he says, I know that I am with you always. Know it. Believe in it. Accept it, that I am with you. So information is given to us for our comfort while we walk this earth, that God is with us all the time, rather than just leaving us in ignorance. Let's say information has been given to us and a promise has been given to us that is seen as very important for our own comfort while we walk and live. We have the promise of the constancy of God with us. And that's a message to all of humanity, both to the living and to the dead, that he is with us all the time. So every step of the journey is with us. He's with us all the time. And even often when people are going through a bad period in their lives, and everyone does, there will be times when you feel almost abandoned, felt alone. And isn't it very affected, often with illness? Illness has a fierce isolating effect on the human person. You're on your own. You may be lying in a bed, you might be sitting in a chair, and you almost can feel at times that the world has abandoned you and nobody really cares. And that is the temptation of old age, that sense of despair. Every part of our lives has some kind of a challenge. Young people often think about sinfulness and something like that as if it only applied to their youth. Every aspect of our life is under challenge, let's put it like that. And often in the older years, senior years, people can feel, let's say, left isolated, abandoned, and feeling that they don't count. And that's the argument I wish to counteract this morning, is that God cares for all of us at every moment of our existence. Know that I am with you always to the end of the age, to the end of time, with his comfort, with his reassurance, and particularly in times of sickness and of sadness, we should be reassured of the nearness of God to us. Right now, if you went out under the star, out in the yard there, and would you be conscious of the stars? No, you wouldn't. If you look up, you can't see nothing. The heavens look just clouds and blue sky. And yet, what's up there at the moment? The stars. We're always looking up at night time. Isn't it interesting that most people during the day never pay attention to the fact that the stars are out there, whereas because they're taken up with the immediate things of life. Whereas the same with God can easily be forgotten in the journey of life as well. By many, many a person that's so taken up with everyday things that they fail to see beyond the immediate things. And the greater things that can come for all of us. The assurance that we're loved by God, that's the first thing. And that he has a future for us and we're never abandoned, no matter what the situation is. So we always feel comfortable in the presence of God, because that's how he wants it, even on days of sadness and so forth. Today now, to the family of the Burke family, they're really feeling human loss. But please God, they should be consoled with the thought that Mary has said her yes to God while she walked this earth. She has said her yes, and that through our prayers and our help today then, that she will see heaven among the angels and saints in glory, and again experience the comfort of Mother Mary, Mother Jesus' mother, who is a mother to all of us. Having said that, my brothers and sisters, now we stand and we pray. We have the prayers of faith as well. God, the Almighty Father, raised Christ, his Son, from the dead. With confidence we ask him to save all his people, living and dead. For all those assembled here to worship in faith, that we may be gathered together in God's kingdom, Lord, hear us. For Mary, who received the body of Christ, the bread of life, that she may be raised up on the last day, Lord, hear us. For the family and friends of Mary, that they may be consoled in their grief as the Lord who wept at the death of Lazarus, his friend, Lord, hear us. For all who care for the sick, that the Lord may reward them for their dedication and kindness, Lord, hear us. For those who bear the cross of pain in mind and body, may they never feel forsaken by God, Lord, hear us. And for all those who have died, particularly the dead of all here present this day, may God give them a place in the kingdom of heaven, Lord, hear us. God of loving kindness, listen favorably to our prayers. Strengthen our belief that your Son has risen from the dead, and our hope that your servants will also rise again. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Look favorably on our offerings, O Lord, so that your departed servant Mary may be taken up into glory with your Son, in whose great mystery of love we are all united through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For as one alone he accepted death, so that we might all escape from dying. As one man he chose to die, so that in your sight we all might live forever. And so, in company with the choirs of angels, we praise you and with joy we proclaim, Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to the disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to the disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess the resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you felt us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, dear Francis, our Pope, Raymond, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember your servant Mary, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that she who was united with your Son in death like his may also be one with him in his resurrection. Remember also our other brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be coursed to eternal life, be praised and glorified through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen. At the Savior's command and form by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as with the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. The kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant our peace and unity in accordance with your will, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Lamb of God, who take away the sins of the world, have a mercy on us. Lamb of God, take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. May the receiving of your body and blood, Lord Jesus Christ, not be meted judgment and condemnation, but through your loving mercy be for me protection in mind and body and a healing remedy. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy to enter my roof, but I say the word and my soul shall be healed.
People.
O Sacrament most holy, O Sacrament divine, all praise and all thanksgiving be every moment thine. We now pray the post-communion prayer. Grant we pray, Lord, that your servant Mary, for whom we have celebrated this Paschal Sacrament, may pass over to a dwelling place of light and peace through Christ our Lord. Amen. We now pray the prayers of farewell and of commendation. Before we go our separate ways, let us take leave of our sister. May our farewell express our affection for her, may it ease our sadness and strengthen our hope. One day we shall joyfully meet her again, when the love of Christ, which conquers all things, destroys even death itself. Now we'll bless the remains with holy water, remind us of our baptism, and we use the incense as well to remind us of our confirmation. Through the sacraments of baptism and confirmation, she became by adoption a sister to Jesus. And going with the actions of the words, saints of God, come to our aid, hasten to meet her, angels of the Lord, receive her soul, present to God the Most High. May Christ, who called you, take it to himself. May angels lead you to the bosom of Abraham. Receive her soul, present to God the Most High. The eternal rest grant unto our Lord, and the perpetual light shine upon her. Receive her soul, present to God the Most High. Into your hands, Father of mercies, we commend our sister Mary, in the sure and certain hope that he kept with all who have died in Christ. She'll rise at him on the last day. We give you thanks for the blessings which you bestowed upon her in this life. They are signs to us of your goodness and of our fellowship with the saints in Christ. Merciful Lord, turn towards us and listen to our prayers. Open the gates of paradise to your servant and help us who remain to comfort one another with assurance of the faith, until we all meet in Christ and we're with you and with our sister forever. In peace then, let us take our sister to her place of rest. May the angels lead you into paradise. May the martyrs come to welcome you and take you to the holy city, the new and eternal Jerusalem. And we end on that great promise of the Scriptures and of the New Testament. I am the resurrection and the life. Whoever lives and believes in me shall never die. Amen. I'm sure the family would like me to thank you for being with them today, and for at the moving last night and attending the funeral parlour, and for all who've gathered here this morning, such good numbers, to pay your respects for Mary, to thank the musician and the sacristans, and also those who are involved with the burials later this morning. So again, may God reward each of you and every single one of you in his own way and his own time. Amen. Father, Son, the Holy Spirit. Amen.
And the dawn is born.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. Our sister Mary has gone to her rest in the peace of Christ. May the Lord now welcome her to the table of God's children in heaven, with faith and hope in eternal life as a sister with our prayers. Let us pray to the Lord also for ourselves. May we who mourn be united one day with our sister. Together may we meet Christ Jesus when he who is our life appears in glory. And we read in sacred scripture, "This is the will of my Father, says the Lord, that I should lose nothing of all that he has given to me, and that I shall raise it up on that last day." And so we bless this place of burial. O God, by whose mercy the faith of the departed find rest, bless this grave and send your holy angel to watch over it. As we bury here the body of our sister, deliver her soul from every bond of sin, that she may rejoice in you and with your saints forever. In sure and certain hope of the resurrection to eternal life through our Lord Jesus Christ, we commend to Almighty God our sister Mary, and we commit her body to the ground. The Lord bless her and keep her. The Lord make his face shine upon her and be gracious to her. The Lord lift up his countenance upon her and give her peace. Dear friends, in reverence, let us pray to God, the source of all mercies. You raise the dead to life. Give to our sister eternal life. Lord, hear us. Lord, you consoled Martha and Mary in their distress. Draw near to us who mourn for Mary, and dry the tears of those who weep. Lord, hear us. Comfort us now to the death of our sister. Let our faith be our consolation, and eternal life our hope. Lord, hear us. We pray for all who are buried in the cemetery in this grave. May their suffering be lessened. May their joy be increased. And may the light of glory shine on them. And may they rest in peace. Lord, hear us. With longing for the coming of God's kingdom, let us pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. God of holiness and power, accept our prayers on behalf of your servant. Do not count our deeds against her, and for her heart she desires to do your will. As her faith united her to your people on earth, so may your mercy join her to the angels in heaven. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. We bow our heads and we pray for God's blessing. Merciful Lord, you know the anguish of the sorrowful. You are attentive to the prayers of the humble. Hear your people who cry out to you in their need and strengthen their hope in your lasting goodness. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. May the prayers of Mary, the Mother of God, who stood by the cross as her son was dying, help those who mourn for Mary, and accompany all of us in our time of need. Eternal rest granted to our Lord, the perpetual light shine upon them. May she rest in peace. May her soul, the soul of all the faithful departed, mercy of God, rest in peace. Amen. As her remains are laid rest in this grave, we now pray the Cathedral of the Rosary, the Resurrection, for eternal repose, for all who lie in this grave and graveyard, and for all the grieving family and those who miss her in this world. The resurrection of Jesus from the dead. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and give us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. It was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. The eternal rest grant her, O Lord, and the perpetual light shine upon her. May she rest in peace. May her soul, the souls of all the faithful departed, the mercy of God, rest in peace. Amen.